What is up, everybody, and welcome back here to the latest episode of this Reading FC RTG Karima. We're into episode number 8 here, and we're getting underway with the first training session of this episode. And as you can see, there's Slavar going up from 70 to 71, which is really good to see. Haaland almost at 70, and we've got to feel there's like Lynch almost reaching their next potential stage, guys. As you can see, coming up in this episode, we've got a game against Brentford on the 29th of September in the Championship, and then heading into October, we've got a game against QPR as well as we progress on through the season quite nicely. Next episode will be West some Brom, and then a game against Millwall as well. So guys, getting underway with the tactics of this game and trying to figure out who we're going to have in the starting lineup. We're going to be looking at these players we've got at the moment and changing quite a lot, because a lot of these players are our reserve squad or not really our first team selection at the moment, guys. So we're changing a few here, making sure we get the right players in the starting lineup, because we want to play our best every week. As you can see here, we're just sorting out some of the players now, and we're going to bring on Barrow here onto the left wing. We're going to be putting on Holland up front. Holland, I'm going to try to say his name right every time, if that's right. And we've got the likes of Okoto here as well, who I like to bring on, as well as Mete. At the moment, I'm having a really hard choice choosing between Okoto and Mete as well on the right wing, guys. And let me know in the comments down below who you think we should be playing as the main starting 11 right winger, Okoto or Mete, because I can't quite decide. As for the left wing, I'm really enjoying Barrow on at the moment, as well as Alvarez. As good as Barrow is, it's nice to have the five-star skills from Alvarez, and then even Saunton, who's a very young player with great potential, is already at like 66, who's, I can't figure out where to place him at the moment. So it's a really tricky choice about who we're going to be playing where in these striking positions, because we actually need more defenders than we do wingers and midfielders. But at the moment, we're not getting any youth defenders through as much. We've got a centre back, but that's about it. So we need some left and right backs from the youth squad, which would be really nice to maybe replace Obita and Yaidom as we get through this career most slowly. But we're gonna have to see how we go, because we've got plenty of time coming up in this season, guys. As you can see here, we're coming into the next game, or the first game in this episode. It's away from home against Brentford after we sorted out a few people in the squad, and we're going to be getting this game underway straight away, guys. Can we get a win here away from home at Brentford? We're going to see how we go now, and here we are getting the game kicked off with Brentford on the ball, and the first chance of this game is going to be coming right now, and it's going to be a substitution firstly in the 56th minute, guys. Nothing happened in that first half or the start of the second half, but we're bringing on Easy for Tonali to try and make a slightly more attacking move in the midfield. And as you can see here, the first chance ends up coming in the 64th minute to Brentford, and they put a ball here through. They cross it into the box, bounces over the players, poor headed clearances, but we just managed to get away. Barrow trying to push forward there, but a poor pass from him. See Sawyers claim it, and Sawyers is on the ball now, lays it forward. They got a chance here. Watkins lays it through there to Mapai, and Mapai goes and puts it in the back of the net in the 66th minute to make it 1-0 to Brentford. Very annoying performance there from Reading so far in this game. We haven't been able to create just about anything going forward, and Brentford finally got their chance in the back of the net there, and unfortunately for us, it was Mapai who went and scored it. So guys, it's going to be 1-0 on the scoreline now to Brentford, with a nice little finish there past the goalkeeper. He's actually scored quite a few goals this season, as you can see. He's on his fifth goal now in the 67th minute of this game, and unfortunately for us, we have gone 1-0 down. But the next chance of the game then comes here in the 68th minute, guys, and this is a really frustrating one for me, because look, I just want it back. I went to make a substitution, as you do when you win the ball back, and I changed a few things around, sorted up the squad a little bit. As you can see here, we're going to bring on some players, and some of the players are out of position, which is really annoying when you go to attacking. It moves the formation and some of the players around. But we're going to be bringing on Okoto on the right. We're going to be bringing on Baldock as center attacking mid, as you can see there, and we're done. But guys, as soon as we unpause it, look what happened. I turned with Lynch on the ball, got tackled by Da Silva, and he just shot straight away, and it somehow went perfectly in the back of the net, in the top, on the roof of the goal, and it's gone in. And he went and made it 2-0 in this game, unfortunately for us, in the 69th minute, just like that, out of nowhere. And that's what happens when you play on ultimate difficulty, guys. You make one mistake and they really punish you for it. Look at this, like, looking at it fully, guys. We just turned on the ball, didn't really see the player when I unpaused it, kind of just turned and carried on, and they went and scored from that, which is really unfortunate. So I thought I'd leave that in there to show you guys why it happened, because that was really frustrating for me. I was so annoyed when that went in the back of the net. Then the finish was so perfect from so far out. As you can see, Okoto now coming on, and so is Sam Baldock for Kelly and Mete. So hopefully they can come on and make a difference in this game. As you can see, in the 81st minute now, pushing forward is Reading, finally with a chance in this one. 81 minutes played, Brentford still 2-0 up, but the ball's coming forward now. We've got a good chance lying down the left wing here. Who's on the ball now? It's Barrow. Barrow crosses it into the back post. Okoto tries to get a header, and Holland takes the shot, and it's gone wide of the goal. Unluckily for him, on his right foot as well. That's probably why it wasn't as accurate as he would have liked it to be. He is a left-footed player, remember, and that just skims wide of the another goal, guys. But guys, we're coming into the 92nd minute now. 1 minute of added time left, and it looks like we aren't going to be bringing this one back today. It looks like it's going to be a loss here for Reading, and no goals to show for it either, which is really unfortunate. As you can see, the final whistle blows here, and we end up with a 2-0 loss, which probably should have been a 1-0 loss, but we didn't get any points from this game. We didn't take anything away from it. And unfortunately for us, we're going to be leaving the game against Brentford here with a very annoyed sense at the moment, guys. We've been playing okay in the league so far. We've been getting a couple of wins and a couple of losses and a couple of draws. So we've kind of been floating around mid-table at the moment. And unfortunately for us, we just haven't been able to get it today. But guys, as you can see here, we're coming into the next game against QPR very soon. And we've got a press conference come up. So we thought we'd have a quick praise of our player, Holland. Because he's been playing pretty well, and I think he scored like 5 goals this season, and we want him to get some more, so we want to hopefully help him get his form up a bit more. Lynch there going up 1 point in this training session to 62, Holland nearly up to 70, which is good, and we got a couple of the other players pushing up slowly, guys. We finally got our monthly scout report through from the Republic of Ireland. That's why I've called this episode bringing in the youth, because we've actually got so many good players or potential players to come into the squad at the moment. We're trying to decide who we should be having, guys. If there's anyone you see that we've been highlighting here that you think is particularly good in the youth squad side of things, let me know in the comments down below, and we'll see what we can do with them. If we want to keep them in the youth squad for a while and train them up through the training, or do we just want to sign them straight into the first team like we've done with some of them. As you can see, we're signing a few players here. The likes of Jason Ennis there, looking pretty interesting, so I might be signing him. He's got some pretty interesting stats. I actually really want a fullback or two, but at the moment none of the players seem to be in the fullback position that are any good. And as you can see, if you look what I'm doing just now, you can actually look at the value of the players to see how good their starting overall is without actually telling you. See, Jason Ennis there is like 200k, which means he's actually a lot better than some of the other ones. As you can see, the overall's here around 55 for that goalkeeper, Andrew McGee. So he's looking pretty interesting. He's not worth an awful lot, but he'll be a good second keeper to have in. 6'5" as well, potential up to 91. So I'd like to see how their potentials go. We've got Julio Barros in here. He's only 15, but he's not actually showing that great potential. Jason Ennis is showing pretty good potential, between 65 and 87, with a 57 overall, but nothing majorly amazing like we got with Okoto and like we got with Alvarez and what's his name down here. But guys, we've got some pretty good players in at the moment. We've got the Lynch as well. Lynch is looking pretty good. He's already at 62. We've got some pretty good players who we did sign in. Look, 62 Alvarez, 63 Okoto. I'm liking Okoto a lot and Alvarez a lot. And we've got Staunton, who I still can't figure out, but he's going to be playing center attacking mid for this game. He's already rated 65 though, which means he's better than most. He's like averagely as good as like all of these Reading players as it is. And he's 16, 17 years old, which is crazy. So all these players are like just as good as the first team, and they're really young, which is going to be great for our future. Meaning as we progress on through the championship season, hopefully into the Premier League, they'll progress on a lot quicker and get a lot better and help us progress on through the league, which would be really cool. As you can see here, we're just filling out the squad. We've got Bollock up front for this one for a change. We've got Okoto, Alvarez on the wings. We're playing Staunton in the center attacking mid position for this game to try him out, and we're just changing up the bench here to make sure we've got a decent bench on the likes of Sims and Aluko, Harriet as well, all on the bench. We've got Bakuna in midfield with Mela, Richards, Laurie McShane, and Gunter in the back with Slavar in goal as well, which is looking pretty good. So hopefully we can get a win out of this one today, because a win is what we need. 3 points. 1 point would be okay, but I think a win here for at home against QPR is definitely in need, because of recent performances. This guy's not really doing what we should be. So we got a bit of a different lineup, because it's quite a close game to the last one. So we had a couple of knackered players in the last game, so we're going to be making sure that these backup slash youth players do well in this game. And the first chance comes here in the 16th minute, coming to Reading, as you can see coming forward now. Baldock laying it through there. We've got a good chance. Staunton chips it over to Bakuna. Bakuna takes one touch, has a shot, and has gone in the back of the net. Bakuna makes it 1-0 in this game. 17 minutes played, and Leandro Bakuna goes and scores a very nice little finish there from the assist from Staunton. So he got a very nice little assist in there. So I did notice that, guys. So make sure when we're watching these, if you guys are watching as in-depthly as me, that we're figuring out who's getting the assists, who's getting the key passes in, who's getting the goals, and who's defending well, not just who's scoring the goals, because we're going to make sure that the team itself is performing well and that they feel good to play with, because the last thing I want is having a team that I don't feel comfortable playing with. So Staunton's coming off now in the 65th minute. He's actually had a pretty good game. game, got an assist, and he's been playing generally well. Harriet's coming on for him, but guys, in the 71st minute, looking forward, a chance here is QPR, and they go and score in the back of the net there with that header. Unfortunately for us, they went and put it in the back of the net. That was like their first chance of the game, really annoyingly. And we're going to be bringing on Aluko now as well as a substitute. So they went and scored the goal here to make it 1-1 in this game in like the 75th minute or something. So we haven't got long. We've got like 15 minutes to try and get a winner out of this one. If we can do it, we'll have to wait and see before we finish up this episode. It'd be good if we could, but otherwise it will be ending 1-1 here, guys. Sixth goal in the championship for him, for Caballero. And we're going to be heading on with the next chance of this game after the substitute. Miller coming off, Aluko coming on to get some pace on the pitch, and hopefully we can make a difference in this one. 72 minutes in, guys. 89 minutes played now. Last minute chance. Can we get the winning goal here? Aluko on the ball, linked to Alvarez. Alvarez of the roulette. Cuts inside. Can he get this cross in? He does, but it hits the player. And goes, that'll play for a corner. Another substitution with Mark Minolti coming on for Sam Baldock. Get a last minute header in from this corner, perhaps, guys. This is my thinking behind this move. Can we get a goal here from this corner? This will be the game winning goal if we can do it with only 2 minutes of added time left. Can we put this one in? Okoto's taking this corner. Puts it into the box there. A header there. No one can get to it, but we've got a chance from Alvarez. He tries a roulette. They're on the edge of the box and leaves the ball behind for some reason. We end up losing the possession. That was such a silly place to lose the ball, and lost it at the feet, guys. And look at this chance coming here for QPR, but the game finishes up at 1-1. So we end up getting 1 point out of this entire episode, which really sucks out of the two games. And we didn't get the result we wanted. And guys, that's going to be it for this episode. Please give us a like, share, and subscribe. We'll be back in the next episode tomorrow with plenty more action and lots of cool things happening, guys. So make sure you stay tuned for that. That is it for this episode. Please give us a like for this series if you're enjoying it, and comment down below, and I'll see you guys all in the next episode. Peace out. Thanks for watching, guys. Make sure you're up to date with all the latest Oscar Strombeck and Theo Kolas episodes as and when they come by clicking the links above here. And don't forget to subscribe with that middle button of GMS there. You can also follow the players now on Instagram and Twitter at Theo Kolas T and Oscar Strombeck K, guys. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you later. Peace.